Hi everyone, welcome back to my videos on continuous time Markov chain. In this video, I'm going to give you another example of application to see how to compute concretely the fraction of time spent in a given state in the long run. So more precisely, I'm going to look at exercise 10.2 from my book. So in this problem, we assume that there is a particle moving clockwise on the vertices of a polygon with n vertices. So that means that the sequence of states visited by the particle is in fact deterministic, but the time at which the particle jumps is random. And we assume that the particle is going to jump from state X to the next vertex at some rate mu sub x, so that depends on the vertex, and the goal is to find the fraction of time the particle spends on each of the vertices. The problem can be solved as usual by looking at the stationary distribution, first proving that there is a unique stationary distribution, finding this stationary distribution, and looking at the coefficient of this stationary distribution. So that's what we are going to do. But in fact, there is another way to think of the problem, thinking of the distribution and the mean of the exponential random variable. And I'm going to give you some alternative answer to this problem. So to solve this problem, it's natural to introduce the continuous time Markov chain that keeps track of the position of the particle. So I'm going to write that xt is equal to the position of the particle at time t. Okay, and so let's fix, I don't know, some vertices like this, let's say five of them, and let's say that this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So in this case, we have five vertices, m is equal to 5. And according to the problem, so what we know is that we move from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, and so on, in a deterministic manner, except that the system does not evolve in continuous in discrete time, it evolves in continuous time, and that's the part of randomness in the process, is that the time spent in each vertex is going to be random, so more precisely it's going to be exponentially distributed. And so we assume that we go from 0 to 1 at right mu 0, from 1 to 2 at right mu 1, and so on, okay, and this one mu 3. And so this is the directed graph representation. I put a weight on the arrows to show the weight. And from that, we can clearly see that clearly the directed graph itself is a directed cycle that goes around all the vertices. So the process is irreducible because it's also finite. We deduce it's positive recurrent. And so the theory of Markov chain again tells us that there must be a unique stationary distribution. To find the stationary distribution, we need to solve pi q equals 0, where q is the intensity matrix. And in this case, the intensity matrix looks like that. So we have, again, we ignore what happens on the diagonal at first. Those coefficients, we find them after. So here, the second coefficient we are going to find is the rate at which we go from 0 to 1. It's mu 0. So we have mu 0 here. And then from 0 to any other state except 1, it's going to be 0. So we have a bunch of zeros after. then here we must have a minus mu 0. And notice that minus this coefficient, that's the overall rate at which the process is going to jump from state 0. And then if you keep going like that, then you should have a mu 1 here, and then again only zeros, and so on. So above the diagonal, you have all those coefficients. On the diagonal, you have minus those coefficients. There is only one exception. So in this corner, you should have a minus mu n again, or mu n minus 1, I guess, because we have m sides, so m vertices. Above, we are going to have mu m minus 2, and it's here that we have mu m minus 1. So there is an exception for the for the last row, just because we go around the circle, so eventually the state that is after m minus 1 is 0. Okay, so here you have the right at which we go from m, the last state, m minus 1 to state 0. Everywhere else, so this is on the diagonal, that's over the diagonal, above the diagonal and below the diagonal, you have only zeros except for this term. So that's our system. Now to solve pi q equals 0, so I'm going to write this here, the goal is to solve pi q equals 0, again, because the theory tells us that irreducibility, positive recurrence, implies existence of a unique stationary distortion. Without doing any calculation, we know already that the set of solutions of this system should be a one-dimensional vector space for which the solution should be a vector such that the sum of the coordinates is finite. Here it's expected, of course, because the state space is finite. So to solve this, we just look at each column one by one. You see that they all look like the same. So the first column is going to tell us that minus mu 0 pi 0 plus mu m minus 1 pi m minus 1 should be equal to 0. So that tells us that mu 0 pi 0 is equal to mu m minus 1 pi n minus 1. Okay? So then the second column tells us that mu 0 pi 0 is equal to mu 1 pi 1. Then mu 1 pi 1 is equal to, here we have a minus negative mu 2, is equal to mu 2 pi 2. So mu 1 pi 1 is equal to mu 2 pi 2. And so on. And you see the pattern. What this says eventually is that in general we have mu x pi x is equal to a constant. So that's what we deduce from this system, is that we must have mu x pi x equals constant. So let's call it C. And the whole story is find C such that the sum of the pi x is equal to 1 to get the stationary distortion. And so for that, you just observe that eventually we get that pi x is of the form this constant divided by mu x. Okay, and so the eventually the sum, we know that the sum of for x in the state space, so from 0 to m minus 1 of the pi x, so it's c over mu x, is equal to 1, okay, which tells you that 1 over c is equal to the sum here, and so that tells you that c eventually must be equal to, so we have the form of our solution here, it's of this form. This equation tells us that 1 over c is equal to the sum of the reciprocal of the right, and so eventually we get c equals 1 divided by this sum, and so we have a, let's say, 1 over mu 0 plus, and we go up to 1 over mu n minus 1. So eventually the solution we obtain is that the fraction of time spent in state x in the long run, fraction of time the particle spend, let's say, at vertex x is going to be given by pi x. Pi x is equal to, so we said this constant divided by mu x. So eventually we have 1 over mu x divided by 1 over mu 0 plus up to 1 over mu n minus 1. So this is the answer. So now, so this is what I'm following here is the typical approach to find a fraction of time spent at a vertex. Again, you do directed graph representation, then argue that the system is irreducible when it is. Then if the state space is finite, we are lucky, we can directly conclude positive recurrence. We know existence and uniqueness of the stationary distribution. If the state space is infinite, you need to do a little bit more work and really solve pi q equals pi and check the set of solutions to really make sure that there is a unique stationary distribution. And then once you have the solution, you can extract from the coefficient of the stationary distribution those fraction of time spent in a state. Here there was another way to really think of the problem. It's just to observe that, let me redo this little pentagon, for instance. And you see that in this case, the intuition behind this formula is the fact that because when you are in state X, the particle is going to jump to the next state with right mu X. This means, and you go back to the definition of the notion of right, this means that the particle is going to spend at this vertex an exponential amount of time with parameter mu x before it jumps to the next state. So eventually the sequence of states visited or sequence of vertices visited by the particle is just deterministic. But what's random is the fraction of time spent in each vertex, each time the particle visits this vertex. And here it turns out that in average, the time the particle is going to spend at state x, each time it visits state x, is going to be the mean of an exponential random variable with parameter mu x. And the mean of an exponential random variable with parameter mu x is 1 divided by mu x, which is exactly this coefficient. So the intuition is exactly this. The fraction of time spent in state X is exactly the expected amount of time spent in state X at each visit in state X divided by the sum of those means for all the vertices. So that gives you some kind of alternative proof of this expression, or maybe if you are not convinced, let's not call that a proof, but at least that gives you some intuitive explanation of what happens in this problem.